framework of Action Research Project. Dear students, when you decide that your research project is to be an action research, and you know that the action research is the design which suits your topic the best and the most, then you would be following a particular framework. So let me just discuss the most common framework of an action research project, right? And it is like a paradigm, the framework or the steps which are involved, particularly when you want to carry out with your action research project. You should know that how would you start and how would you follow various steps in order to accomplish a project which is based on action research, right? So the point is that you would start with the identification of a problem which is to be solved in your action research project, right? So that identification of a problem is really important. You are required to know it thoroughly, right? Formally, informally, you must know and define your research problem. That's the starting point. When it is defined, then you should also think about some limitations and delimitations, right? So defining and delimiting the problem. Then you would think about analyzing causes of the problem. And when you are analyzing the causes of the problem, then you would formulate your hypothesis, right? Or hypotheses, right? That what is the proposed solution to that research problem? So that would be your analyzing the causes of the problem. Then you would, of course, after the formulation and the submission of the hypothesis, you would think about the design of your action research project. That how would you collect data? How would you analyze data? How would you carry out with various procedures? And how and which instrument you would use, right? So that is design. And when the design for testing of the action hypothesis is decided, then you would think about, the conclusion or the research project action which are to be taken, right? So these are, the steps which are involved, and that's the framework for action research project. Let me also share with you the detail of such, points. So you are starting with a working topic, right? In the beginning, you may not be coming up with a final topic, but you are coming up with, the crude idea of the topic, the working topic, right? So the working topic, and then you would define your objectives. What are the objectives of this action research project? And then what system of the project work, right? So how would you decide the particular nature of an action research? What kind of action research it is, right? So that is to be solved. And then the evaluation of the project, that whether the project is based on a quality research framework, right? So is the design authentic? Is it valid, reliable, right? So you would challenge your design and you would explore it further. So that's the evaluation of the project. Then the estimation of the expenditure. You should not be planning something which is beyond your resources, right? So the expenditure must be within your control, right? The investment of the time must be in your control. It should be appropriate according to your level of the degree, if it's an academic research, and it should be based on a particular appropriateness of the, the nature of topic, right? So the estimation of expenditure is really important. Then sampling. So within sampling, the detail is that you would decide which institute and how many institutions, how many branches. So is it going to be like a primary school or elementary school or secondary school, higher secondary school? So what institution would you like to include in your research? Or is it going to be a university, right? And what number of the institutions are required? How many number of institutions are required to be the part of the sampling? Then teachers or students? How many students? Which sections? How many teachers? Based on what qualification? So these are the points which are to be explored by a researcher who wants to go for action research. Because the sampling detail would actually bring in the quality and the reliability of your research. And of course, this sampling also include the sampling techniques, right? So how would you decide? Is it going to be like randomized sampling, right? So these are the points which are to be addressed by a researcher who wants to go for action research. The facilities involved. You must also explore those facilities which are involved. like the facilities must be, you know, helping you out. If you are going to talk about something in your research project, but the facility is not available, then you may not be able to finish your study, right? So you must analyze the facilities which are involved. And when you are done with all these steps, you know your framework now. You know the paradigm of your study now. Then you can start your study. So these are the points which are to be followed when you want to go for an action research project.